Hello, hello. I am Linda White, and this is Shikuri's Time Capsule, a mini podcast where I reminisce about food, fashions, and fads from decades gone by. Today, I have a question for y'all. Does anybody out there still sew? As in sewing your own clothing? I've had a few sewing machines myself over the years, but I never really used them all that much except to do occasional crafts. And then a few years ago, I really got into strip quilting. But back when I was growing up in the 60s and 70s, it was a lot more common for women to have sewing machines at home where they'd make their own outfits. My mom, who briefly worked in the New York garment industry before she got married in the late 50s, was an avid sewer when we were growing up. She used to make our school outfits and the occasional Halloween costume. I remember going to the store with her and looking through the sewing pattern books. Remember those? These were huge, glossy catalogs with colorful photos and illustrations of hundreds of different patterns. The dime store we used to go to had a small fabric department in the back corner, and they would periodically sell the outdated catalogs for a couple bucks. I used to love when Mom would bring these books home, and I'd spend hours looking at all the different fashions. Now, for me, it was the teenage version of the Sears Wish book. The main catalogs we got then were Simplicity and McCall's. I remember there were also Butterick and, I believe, Vogue pattern books also, but my favorites were the Simplicity and McCall's because they were huge books with thousands of pictures to gawk at. I remember my two favorite parts of these books were the bridal and formal wear section and the Halloween costumes. Now, luckily, McCall's and Simplicity are still around online where you can still gaze at all the pictures. I also remember a lot of the fabric bolts had that same chemically smell of flame retardant. In fact, even the ready-to-wear clothing back then often reeked of that same nasty retardant chemical. Sounds strange, but I can still remember that odor. I also was fascinated by the bolts of all the different ribbons, braiding, fringe, tassels, and pom-poms. The gold drapery tassels were always my favorite because when you turn them upside down, they look like little doll heads with long hair. Sure, we still have fabric shops like Joann, and even some Walmarts have decent sewing sections. And like I said before, the pattern books have moved online, and the patterns cost four times as much as they did back in the day. But I still get very nostalgic when I recall the cozy atmosphere of that small sewing section in the back corner of our local Five and Dime. So once again I ask, who out there still sews? And what do you like to sew? Like I said earlier, I'm more into strip quilting now. I made my own bedspread a couple years ago, as well as lap quilts for family and friends. What's currently under your needle? Drop me a line at shikuri2, that's C-H-A-K-K-U-R-I, and the number 2 at yahoo.com, or leave a comment on this podcast Instagram feed at Shikuri's Time Capsule, all one word. Looking for a good read? Check out my two books that are currently available on Amazon, Yellow Gal, Queen of the Montclair, and The Belle of Camden County, both written by me, Linda M. White, are available in both paperback and digital formats. They are both set in Florida and Georgia during the late 19th and early 20th century. And they both deal with the subject of racial identity. If you like romance, dramas, and period pieces, these books are for you. Once again, we come to an end of another podcast. And as always, I thank each and every one of you for listening. Stay safe and may you always be blessed. Adios.